Praise the Lord, precious saints, and welcome today to another prophetic utterance coming to you. Today I have something special for you because this last and past night I had a dream, and just before I woke up, it became very prophetic in nature. And a messenger of the Lord came to me with a scroll, and the words were spoken from the scroll that said, "Fall 26th of September 2020. And then the Lord spoke into my spirit and said that this date is very significant in the prophetic calendar within this hour. Then I woke up from that dream and I started searching for this date and understanding fall, because you've got to understand that in the English language which Australians use, it's a little bit different to American English, where you may say tomatoes, we may say tomatoes, or vice versa. And you know, you also use the seasons, where we will say autumn, you'll say fall. So I understood that this message was specifically to do with the United States and also to do with Israel, because we know that the seasons in the time of September is also fall or autumn in Israel as well as it is in America. So here in Australia in September we will be going into spring. So I knew that this prophetic message was specifically to do with the United States and also in regards to Jewish festivals. And as I started to search, I understood that the time of September, as we know, it is the Jewish New Year, which goes into the Feast of Trumpets. And then between the Feast of Trumpets and Yom Kippur, which is the Day of Atonement, which this year will be the 27th and the 28th, is the 10 days of repentance. Now, those 10 days of repentance are very significant for Israel. And then when they cross over from the Day of Atonement into the Feast of Tabernacles, it is a time now for praying for the nations, praying for repentance for the nations. Hallelujah. And Jesus even stood up and said in that particular Feast of Tabernacles and said that he is the living water, spoken about the water blessing that takes place through the Feast of Tabernacles. So I knew that we were in a very prophetic timing right now. And the Lord instructed me to ensure that I initiate a 10 days of repentance, revival, fasting, and praying that will take place and will cross right over into the 28th of September. Now, I know that this date is very significant. And then I also understand that America has a history of a revival. And if we go back to the year of 1857, now at that time in 1857, there was many things going on. There was a stirring up of civil war and different things. There was rebellion. There was a stock market crash. There was all sorts of things going on in society. There was instability. There was a lot of things going on. But there was one man that on the 23rd of September, he had a small gathering of six men, and his name was Jeremiah, and he started to pray with six men. And within these prayer meetings, they would have a rule that you would have 5 minutes to pray. So it wasn't just someone giving a preaching message or anything like that. It was actually people praying, and you had a 5 minute rule that you could pray for 5 minutes, and people would also send their prayer requests to this meeting. But on the first meeting was the 23rd in 1857. Now, at the same time, around the world in different places, I mean in Europe, I mean in England, I mean in Ireland, I mean in South Africa, I mean even in Tasmania, God was also doing a revival thing around the same time. Now, Jeremiah was a businessman. And 2 weeks after, on the 23rd of September in 1857, there was a stock market crash. Now, that would have been going 2 weeks into October, which would have been the Feast of Tabernacles. Now, what happened is that those meetings that started off with six people gradually grew to about 10,000 men coming together, just men coming together to pray in these particular prayer meetings. And they would be up to three times a day, and gradually this prayer movement built throughout all of America, eventually going to spread throughout the whole world to 50 different nations. I mean that it even went to England, and it turned upside down entire villages and towns for the glory of God. Even that they had to defund the police because there was no use for police. Now, we see them trying to do that today. They're trying to defund police for the wrong reasons. But back then, they were doing it because there was no crime. The problem is today, there is still crime. So only revival can defund the police or shut the police down because there's no crime to attend to. This is the type of revival. So this revival spread throughout the whole of America. And it is said that across America, places like Chicago, places like St. Louis, and so forth, these places were on fire. You know, around that time, pastors in America in 1 week would be baptizing up to 20,000 people. It was a serious revival. The lay people would want to volunteer in the church, and there was huge waiting lists because there were so many people volunteering to do Sunday school, to do different things that was happening at that time. I believe that we are on the brink to know that, hey, you know what? We're living in a time that God is saying, hey, He's coming back soon, people. Now, I've always been a big adamant, promoter of revival. But the truth is, the rapture could happen any moment. So we need to be ready. And I believe that at this time, as we're going into Yom Kippur, which is the time of atonement, which is the day that the high priest goes into the Holy of Holies. Now, the requirement of a high priest is that they must intercede on behalf of the people, and that they must also have a compassion for the people's needs. Now, there is a difference between a high priest and a prophet. A prophet spoke on behalf of God, where a high priest spoke to God on behalf of the people. The high priest couldn't forgive sin because he was just human. Hallelujah. But he also communicated on behalf of the people. And I believe that is what we are meant to do in this hour. We need to go into a time of repentance, a time of prayer, of 10 days fasting leading up to the 28th, or if not beyond, into the Feast of Tabernacles. And we need to be praying that God would not only forgive our sins, because that's what the Jewish people did for the 10 days, they would repent. They would even pay off debts. They would go and make their debts right so that they would come out of the Day of Atonement clean. So if you have debts or anything, if there's any unforgiveness in your life, this is the time to go and make right with people in this hour, because the Lord specifically gave me this day of the 26th, which is in between the 10 days of repentance, which then crosses over into the 27th, which is the 27th goes into the 28th as the Day of Atonement. Now, we know the Day of Atonement is the day that the high priest goes in and makes that, makes that prayer and intercession on behalf of the people. And we know that it is one day and 1 hour that the heavens open. Now, Jesus said, no one knows the day or the hour of His coming. Not even the Son of Man, not even the angels of heaven, but only His Father in heaven. Hallelujah. So a day and an hour, all these things that coincide. See, Jewish feasts still act prophetically to us. So when we look to these things, we understand prophetically that Jesus came to fulfill all these things. But it is very symbolic for us to be praying for revival, praying for America, because if America falls, it's going to affect Christianity all over the world. We know that the enemy, the Antichrist, has set the stage. He hasn't been revealed, but he's set the stage. The culture is being set. Everything that is being playing out, everything that we have been taught by the fake media and everything that is going on today. People, we are living in the end times. But I believe, just like this businessman, Jeremiah, who started a prayer meeting, and people would send prayer requests to these prayer meetings, and all of a sudden they'll read it, and a wife would say, I'm praying for the salvation of my husband. All of a sudden, five men in that prayer meeting would put up their hands and say, I am that husband, and would repent of their sins and turn from their sins. People that were coming in ships, like captains of ships that would be coming into the America, into the port areas, would be under a strong conviction and would go to these prayer meetings and give their life to Christ. Even people that were coming anywhere close, people would come to Christ Jesus. This was a lay prayer movement that was crossing out, and people wanted to come to these prayer meetings because God was bringing such a strong conviction. I believe this is the hour of those 10 days fasting that you should also initiate prayer within your home, prayer within your workplace, prayer amongst your peers, prayer in any shape or form. I believe it is a time for us to pray, time for us to repent of our sins, time for us to get right before the Lord, just as it was with King Hezekiah when Isaiah the prophet came to him and says, get your house in order. I believe that this is a time for us to prepare, as though the day of the Lord could come. And at the twinkling of an eye, you know, the twinkling of an eye is even faster than the blink of your eye. That's how fast the snatching away will be of His blameless church that is ready for Him in this hour. We need to prepare, people. We need to prepare for revival. We need to prepare for His coming. We need to prepare. This is a warning. I believe this is a direct prophetic warning that was given, because it was so strong in my spirit and I didn't shake it off until I shared it with my wife and also another brother. And they said, wow, Pastor, this is intense. This is intense. We are living in this hour. It is time for us to repent. It is time for the United States to repent so that God can bring revival to your nation and also bring revival to all other nations. This is a call for the nations to repent. This is a call for the Church of Jesus Christ to repent, that revival may come, that God would stir up like a revolution, that there would be a change of understanding and everything, that people would come and draw to close. Now, imagine this. There was a stock market crash. There was a worse time for America at that time, but it drove people to prayer. What's it going to take to get people's attention? What's it going to take to get our attention to know that we need to repent? We need to come back to God. Even after this corona situation, have the churches really repented the way that we should do? Or we're just taking all this stuff lightly? We need to get right with God. 2 Chronicles 7:14 says, if my people who are called by my name would humble themselves and pray and turn from their wicked ways, then I would hear from heaven, I will forgive their sins, and I will heal their land. God wants to do something. I believe He wants to pour out His Spirit upon all flesh. I believe something significant is going to take place even on the 26th that will stir up something within God's calendar. I believe it is a time for us to seek the Lord. I believe it is a time for us to prepare ourselves, starting with our families and then spreading out to the nations, just as it was with that prayer movement. Just as I believe God is going to do something, and He was using lay people. He was using lay people. Imagine pastors in 1 week would baptize up to 20,000 people. You imagine the numbers with the greatest outpouring outpouring of His Holy Spirit that I believe God is going to bring to the earth and bring a change to our situation. God wants to bring a change to your situation. Are you open to receive what God has for you? Today is the day of repentance. Hallelujah. The Bible says, according to Acts 3, verse 19, it says, "Repent, therefore, and be converted, that your sin may be covered in the blood, and that times of refreshing may come in the presence of the Lord." It is time to repent. It is time for the nations to repent. It is time for repentance revival. It is time for people to catch the fire of repentance revival as we prepare for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. This is not a time to be playing church. This is not a time to be playing programs. This is not a time to be feeding ourselves with all the worldly junk. This is time for us to get right before God. This is a time for us to repent and come back to God and live holy and righteous lives for Him. He is a holy God. Without holiness, you will not see God. It's as simple as that. Whether you believe Him or not, you're going to meet your Maker one day, and it's time to repent and come back to Him. He's a holy God. I pray today that each person that is listening to the sound of this tongue would take heed to this warning, would take heed to this message, and also would also be convicted to also to join us, to participate in 10 days of fasting and praying as we go throughout this period of time of the 10 days of repentance as we cross over into the Day of Atonement, Yom Kippur Day, which is the Day of Atonement. I pray that through the blood of Jesus Christ, He has become our atonement once and for all, precious saints. Thank you, Jesus. We bless your holy name. We thank you, Lord, for what you're going to do. And I pray for each person that you will touch them from the top of their head to the soles of their feet right now. Lord, I pray for each person that is listening. Whatever you are going through today, Jesus is the answer to you. He is going to make a way of escape for you, precious saints. He's going to make a way of escape for you. Just press into God. Just press into God. Press into God in this hour and know that your fasting and your praying is not in vain. Nothing you do is in vain in this hour, but I believe we're on the brink of a breakthrough that is coming. Just as the messenger of the Lord, the angel of the Lord has given me the scroll, has given me this date, you know, and is given and spoken in a way that's not even in my English, because we say autumn, not fall. And September for us is spring. So I know this message is for the United States, is also connected to Israel as the Jewish feast and so forth. It is time for us to pray. And whatever the enemy meant for harm, God will turn it around. God would relent of any judgment that is supposed to come, and that He will relent of those things and bring about His mercy and show revival to the nations of Jesus Christ. He loves you today. He is speaking to you today. And God wants to do great things in your life. If you will just give your heart to God, if that's you today, and you know that you haven't been living for the Lord, then we're going to repent now. Repentance starts right here, right now. Don't wait for the 10 days. Start now. If that is you today, I want you to repent of your sins. Maybe you know that if you were to die today, you would not please the Lord. So I just want you to repeat this prayer. Say, "Heavenly Father, today I repent of all of my sins. I come back to you. And through your precious blood, I am forgiven today. Thank you, Jesus. I receive you as my Lord, God, and personal Savior. And from today, I am born again. I am cleansed. I am covered in the blood of Jesus Christ. Today, Father, I commit myself fully to the work of God, that you would give me the gift of the Holy Spirit to continue in obedience to you, and that by your grace, I will get through, in Jesus' name. Amen." If you've said that prayer right now, then you have received Jesus Christ as your Lord, God, and Savior. If you've said that prayer right now, you are forgiven and your backsliding is going to change. God is a God that is forgiving God. The Bible says, according to 1 John 1:9, if we confess our sins, He is faithful and just to forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Today is the day of salvation, saints. Let us prepare as you receive this message. May the Lord bless you and keep you, and may His face shine upon you and give you His peace, His shalom. May the Lord bless you. From Robert Clancy. Yes, that's right. This is Pastor Robert Clancy from Narrow Path Ministries in Perth, Western Australia. It is time to catch the fire of repentance revival as we prepare for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Shalom, shalom, shalom. And if you've liked this utterance today, we encourage you to subscribe to our YouTube channel. You can also follow us on Facebook or Instagram. Go to our free website, repentancerevival.com. And also, you know, precious saints, we always have the Friday fastings, which starts from Thursday evening all the way to Friday 6 p.m. I encourage you to always participate in that corporately, that you yourself will personally seek the Lord in your intimacy time with God. We bless you today from my family to yours. God bless you. We love you. Lord, we are praying for you, precious saints. Shalom, shalom, shalom.